With a shower of rain. We stopped in the colonnade and went on in sunlight into the Hofgarten and drank coffee and talked for an hour. Bin gar keine Russin, stamm aus Litauen, echt Deutsch. And when we were children, staying at the Archduke's, my cousin's, he took me out on a sled and I was frightened. He said, Marie, hold on tight. And down we went. In the mountains, there you feel free. I read much of the night, and go south in the winter. What are the roots that clutch? What branches grow out of this stony rubbish? Son of man, you cannot say or guess, for you know only a heap of broken images where the sun beats. And the dead tree gives no shelter, the cricket no relief, and the dry stone no sound of water. Only there is shadow under this red rock. Come in under the shadow of this red rock, and I will show you something different from either your shadow at morning striding behind you, or your shadow at evening rising to meet you. I will show you fear in a handful of dust. Burial of the dead. April is the trellis month. Leading silence out of the dead sand. Mixing memory and desire. Filling dull roots with spring rain. Thank you.
excitement for a while, the question of whether or not there is an alien intelligence becomes moot. There is an alien intelligence. And then what is it? And the choices as are, and maybe you can help me add more, the choices are, it is a straightforward B-movie extraterrestrial of some sort that is, God knows what reason, but coming at us through this. That's one thing. It is the Gaian mind in some version of that. In other words, it's the integrated intelligence of the biome of the planet that, because probably of the historical crisis, is actually noticed us and is trying to twiddle our knobs in some dimension we're not even aware of. So that extraterrestrial Gaian mind could be some strange technological experiment launched from the future. In other words, words that communicate with us. They seem to have values, have problems. Maybe they are human beings of some sort. Perhaps it's a time travel project in some distant century that has decided that the key screw-up occurred in the 20th century and they're going back trying to twiddle the knob. Notice that these theories have greater and alarming. This is the shamanic one, that these that this entity, this contact, whatever it is somehow coming from the afterworld. That this is a project launched from an ecology of souls. That somehow the erasure of the boundary between the living and the dead is what is at stake here. I mean, now this is from, you know, raised as logical positivist. This is the one you would choose to ask. I think it's much evil to believe in meddling extraterrestrials than that, you know, Uncle Herman and Aunt Fanny are somehow reaching in from the great beyond. Yeah.
Thank you.
made this very clear. The flying saucer, which haunts our collective imagination, is a totality symbol that is in the unconscious, but it is moving toward conscious appearance, and its peculiar mercurial interfacing with the observer indicates that it is something on the borderline between the conscious and the unconscious mind. But that's a temporal, a temporary situation, and conceivably this thing is moving toward us, and it vibrates with the alien, but it is in fact ourselves. And there is a kind of recurso here, where the thing we lost at the descent from Eden is actually, you know, on a collision course, coming back again. This is the idea of the archaic revival, that we can really deconstruct reality in a fairly radical way. Made this very clear. The flying saucer, which haunts our collective imagination, is a totality symbol that is in the unconscious, but it is moving toward conscious appearance, and its peculiar mercurial interfacing with the observer indicates that it is something on the borderline between the conscious and the unconscious mind. But that's a temporal, so you're perfectly free to believe it was just a hallucination, or you're perfectly free to believe, you know, that it was an ambassadorial contact with an alien mind. So you're perfectly free to believe it was just a hallucination, or you're perfectly free to believe, you know, that it was an ambassadorial contact with an alien mind.
Thank you. Thank you.